गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ ज्ञान निकेतन गर्ल्स स्कूल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ वेरी फ्रेश चैप्टर, दैट इज ट्राइबल ड्यूरिंग द कॉलोनियल रूल। नाउ बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द ट्राइबल सोसाइटी एंड हु वर द ट्राइबल पीपल। सी, ट्राइबल सोसाइटीज वर एब्सोल्युटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दोज विच एग्जिस्टेड इन बिग सिटीज। दे डिड नॉट फॉलो द सोशल रूल्स एंड रिचुअल प्रिस्क्राइब बाय द ब्राह्मण्स इन एंशियंट एरा, बिकॉज दे वेर ऑलरेडी डिवाइडेड इंटू सोसाइटीज एंड इंटू न्यूमरियस अनइक्वल क्लासेस, एंड दीज सोसाइटीज वेर नोन एज ट्राइब्स। नाउ देयर वर अ यूनिक बॉन्ड ऑफ किनशिप अमंग मेंबर ऑफ each tribe. There were not only one tribe but different tribes, and they have unique bond of kinship, and their main source of livelihood was agriculture. However, hunter and gatherer or herders were also there, but main source were agriculture. And some tribes were also seen as being nomadic and kept on moving from one place to another, whereas many of them lived in areas like forest, hills, deserts and places which were difficult to reach. Now let us start. See, tribal people constitute 8% of nation's total population. Means in our country, out of total population, 8% of people are tribal people. And where are the people, these people living? Majority of these tribal people live in Jharkhand or Orissa, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Northeastern State, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, whereas some of the tribal people live in areas like Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, Gujarat, Rajasthan and Andaman and Nicobar Island. Now see, formerly tribes were located in dense forest and hills which were cut off later. Means it is said that earlier these tribal people used to live in hills, forest, mountains, desert, but since these areas were cut off by the non-tribal people, they have to shift from forest to cities or villages. So tribal culture were also seen as primitive in nature. Now what do you mean by primitive in nature? See, primitive nature is characterized by features that may include, which we can say as lack of a written language, relative isolation, means they live in isolation, separated from other society. They live in small population, small group. Relatively simple social institutions are set up, and technology are very less, or we can say there are no technologies used in these societies, and they are generally slow rate of socio-cultural change. So this is what we call primitive in nature. Now the word tribe here means a social division within a traditional society which consists of a group who are interlinked families or communities. Means they are interlinked with each other in some or another manner, okay, and they share a common nature, dialect or language. Now a tribe consists of a social group existing before the development or outside of country, okay. See, now tribal societies, when we talk about tribal society, there are a number of characteristics which have been seen as establishing the tribal identity, the identity of these tribal people, which include language, religious affiliation, economic pattern, geographic location and self-identification. Means it could be said that these tribal people are formed in a group on basis of their language, on basis of their religion, on basis of their economic pattern, on geographic location or identification of self-being. So these tribal people often practice shifting cultivation also. Now what is shifting cultivation? It is plantation, planting of for a number of season, for planting any crop for a number of season and then abandoning that land for a lengthy period of time and shifting to other land. That is what we call shifting cultivation. Means they practiced shifting cultivation very often, means clearing of land or fueled by slabs or burning method. Means either they would clear the forest by tools, or they would burn that area in order to do cultivation. So now, tribal society tends to be egalitarian. Now, what do we mean by term egalitarian? See, egalitarian particularly is believing in or based on the principle that all people are equal and deserve equal right and opportunity. Means each and everyone there are treated as equal. So they believed in egalitarian, and leadership are based on ties of kinship and personality on hereditary status. Means here it was not believed in tribal society. We do not see that the kinship, the leadership is based on hereditary, as we see at we have seen earlier in ancient India or medieval India. It was not hereditary, it was based on kinship and the personality of a people. Means the oldest member of a tribal society would be the leader of that tribe. Here it was said so. So now, there are certain things that we see in tribal society, like how the tribal society changed over time. See, the context earlier, they were seen that they were bounded in the area of hills, forest, mountains. But later, when they came in contact with outside world, it had several effects on the tribal society's culture and tradition. It had some positive effect also, and it had some negative effect also. Positive, we can say that they came to understand different societies' ritual culture outside the world. And negative, we can say that the egalitarian system, the bond that the tribal society had earlier when they used to live in forest, was it changed over period when they came in contact with the outside world. And they generally, earlier it was seen that they generally worship their clan god. Means each tribe had their particular deity or god, but contact with the outsider made them aware about people, societies and features. As I said, when they came in contact with the different society, they came to know the reality of the world, that what different things are there in the world and how different societies and cultures are prevailing in the world. And at the same time, at that time it was seen that Christian missionaries were working over tribal areas, and they were converting these people into Christianity over the promise of giving them land, education and better social status and money. And over this bribe, they were trying to convert these tribal people into Christianity. But there were many disillusion, because most of the promises were not kept. Means they were not fulfilled. They did not get any land, they did not get any money, and they were disillusioned, and they reverted to their original religion. Means whatever they were believing, their original religion, their original tribe culture, they started to follow the same. Okay, now these were the changes that were seen in tribal society after they came to know the outside world. Now, how were the tribe in the 19th century? See, tribal people in the 19th century, we see that Britishers had dominated most of the area in India. And the tribal society was also being seen dominated by these Britishers. The Britishers' dominance on India was almost complete by the middle of 19th century. And their main particularly purpose from tribal area was the cultivation of crops. Means to grow more and more crops. So they did away with the traditional right of the tribe. Earlier they used to do the cultivation through the traditional method that these tribal people were doing, and started exploiting them for their own selfish end. Means later it was seen that these tribal people were being exploited by the Britishers, who particularly came for the cultivation to the tribe. Means how they were exploited. The settlements, there were different settlements were brought up on the people that we had I have explained in the previous chapter. Different settlements came, and दीज सेटलमेंट्स वेयर लाइक परमानेंट सेटलमेंट रैयतवाड़ी महलवाड़ी पर्टिकुलरली परमानेंट सेटलमेंट वॉज इम्प्लीमेंटेड ऑन ट्राइबल सोसाइटीज. सो दे स्टार्टेड द ब्रिटिशर्स स्टार्टेड टू एक्सप्लॉयट दीज ट्राइबल पीपल ऑल्सो विच लेड टू द डिससेटिस्फेक्शन अमंग द ट्राइबल्स एंड दे डिड नॉट लाइक द इंटरफेरेंस विद द राइट कल्चर एंड कस्टम्स ऑफ द ट्राइबल विच द ब्रिटिशर्स वर डूइंग. And as a result, a number of tribal revolt was seen during the 19th century against the Britishers. So this was the situation of tribe in the 19th century. Now, what changes occurred in tribal economies, in tribal societies? See, the tribal economies were self-sufficient as they sustained on forest product and farming. Their main major occupation purpose was agriculture. They used to live their livelihood through farming and forest product. However, interference of British government restricted their right in forest because different laws and acts were imposed on the forest and the tribal people. So the interference of British government restricted their right in forest and land means forest. The act that were imposed by the Britishers, the act said that the forest product directly is under the Britishers. So the tribal people had no right over the forest product. So these all restricted the right of the tribal people and they were not allowed to use the forest product. So again, they were compelled to look for other avenues for their livelihood. Means they have to see for other source of the living. They had to look for other method how they could earn livelihood. And the tenancy rights were also taken away from them. Now, what do we mean by tenancy right? Tenancy right that was taken over by these people. Tenancy means particularly is possession of land or property as a tenant. Okay, means we particularly tenancy is taking over a land by or a property as a tenant, which means holding of an state or a mode of holding and state, specifically the temporary possession. It is not temporary, it is not permanent, it is given on lease. Okay, so here what happened, the tenancy was also seen. Sorry, tenancy refers to the possession or occupation of land, means land, building or other property by title through a lease or on permanent payment of rent. So this is what we know as tenancy, and these tenancy were also taken away from these tribal people, and they were merely reduced to a landless laborers. Means from tribal people where they had their own right over land, where they were using the forest product, now they were laborers in the eyes in the hand of the Britishers. Means Britishers started to see these tribal people as landless laborers now who shared crops. Okay, during those days when due to environment factors crops failed, the condition of these tribals were aggravated. Means the tribal condition was very poor at the time, that when famines or crop famine took place or the failure of crop was seen, they had to live from hand to mouth. The condition of these tribal people became worse during those period. So this is what the tribal society was, and the change in tribal society was seen after the Britishers were involved in this tribal society and when the tribal people came in contact with the outside world. So till today we stop here. In next class I'll continue the chapter. For now, thank you and have a nice day.